Hey guys, if there's anyone new watching this video, I figure if there are any of my videos recently that people that aren't already subscribed will watch, perhaps it's this one. Yeah, so my name's Alexa. I am, well now I'm a sophomore, but I was a freshman at I don't know, rising sophomore. That's the way to go about. Ow, this is a great filming location. I am a rising sophomore at Harvard University studying economics and government. And of course, because I am a college student, I was kicked out of university in preparation and management of COVID-19. Specifically, Harvard actually, I believe, was the first university to fully send students home. We were given the deadline to leave on March 15th. And that was a 5-day time span that we had to get the fuck out, essentially. My semester is now ended. I'm back home. I am in the most peculiar filming location. This is my storage room in my house. So don't make any comments like, what is this? This is plywood because there's construction going on in here. And this is a storage bin. Because this is the storage room. I left my ring light at my grandparents' house. Among all the other chaos that this university transfer has led to. So I'm just gonna kind of walk you through everything that happened to me and then how I'm doing now. So it's gonna be kind of like a timeline kind of video. I was, as I said, given the deadline to be out of Harvard University by March 15th. And I actually did film kind of like a vlog during this time frame when, you know, I just found out about it and how I was coping. So if you are interested in seeing that, I will link that up in the cards. I'm looking a little rough in some of those videos because it was a very tough time. But yeah, at first I was reacting very poorly to everything that was going on. I was completely devastated, honestly, because I'm from a very, very small rural town. Like, think even smaller than the small town that you think of as small, okay? There's less than 100 people where I live, okay? I had not really that much of a community at home. I didn't really have a lot of really close friends. And when I went to college, I really just found all of these people that I really connected with, whether that was through my clubs. I was in the Harvard band and the Quidditch team, actually. And also my other friends that I had made along the way. And then for all of this to be ripped away so quickly, I'm sure anyone else that was going to college can relate to this specific experience. It's like, well, shit, man. Like, I finally find my place in the world. I make all of these friends, some of which are seniors, and now I'm suddenly not going to see them again for a really long time, if I do ever see them again at all. That's really crummy. So, of course, I was dealing with that. I live very far away from school. It takes, if I was to drive straight from Cambridge to where I live without making any stops, it takes 24 hours. And, of course, with this virus that is being spread, especially through mass gatherings of people, it would not have been intelligent at all for me to take a plane home. And so that meant that my mom and my uncle had to come and get me. That entire journey, I think, took about 3 days because of the way that we were stopping and rationing out who was going to drive, where we were going to park and sleep, because it was unsafe to just stop at a random place in the middle of the highway. And then I got home and I had about a week's worth of buffer room before I had to start doing any of my actual work, my homework, because most of the professors were very, very lenient, saying, okay, well, shit, you all had to pack up all your crap, throw it into random boxes and get the fuck out. So we're going to give you like a week or two to adjust. But then I got home and I realized just how poorly fitted my home life is to being able to take Harvard level courses online and try to take them well. My internet is not the best. This video that you're watching right now, I guarantee you it took over 12 hours to upload from my house, which is great when you're having to use Zoom to do digital lectures, some of them live, some of them recorded, when you have to upload big ass PDFs and send papers through the email. Am I like 80 years old? And you have to send papers through email to your professors and your teaching fellows and whatnot. It's certainly not a place where a person with very spotty internet connection and no service, so I can't just decide, all right, I'm going to use my personal hotspot. Because even though I do have a hotspot, I get one bar of service if I'm lucky where I live. So that was definitely not the way to go about it. And then, as you might be able to guess from the environment in which I am standing, there's a lot of construction and such going on in my house, which means that there are piles of wood and displaced items everywhere, therefore making just general living here with other people, in this case my mom and her boyfriend, much more difficult than it was at school. And it's certainly more difficult when you take into account the education that I'm supposed to be balancing along with this kind of tight living situation. And so I decided that the best way for me to possibly try to get something that resembled a Harvard education was... So we have Yorkie puppies right now. You might hear them growling and barking in the background. And so I decided that the best way that I could try to maintain at least a little bit of stability and try to get an education that in some way reflected the education that I would have had on campus was to pack up all my shit again and drive to my grandparents' house, which is, I think, like 150 miles away from where I live. So yeah, I spent 2 months living there with my grandparents, and I really do appreciate the fact that they let me stay there. They had, for the most part, a pretty decent internet connection. They had a big dining room table that I was able to spread out my laptop, my books, my notebooks, all of my materials on that I wouldn't have had access to here, because I don't even have a desk at home. There was no reason for me to have a desk at home because I was on campus. I didn't live anywhere near my house when I was doing school, and when I was in high school, I certainly didn't need it because honestly, I didn't spend that much time doing homework in high school. And so that was another reason why I had to flee my house and go to my grandparents' house. And for the most part, I'd say it worked all right. In the beginning, I was kind of honestly having one of those, I'm gonna be productive, I'm gonna use this time to the best of my ability, and I'm gonna fucking kill it moments. You know, when you just get started on, say, like a diet, if that's the thing that you do, it's like the same kind of high. For a while, I was getting up on time, I was sticking to a pretty good schedule, I was attending all of my lectures, it was going great. And then it wasn't going so great. Typically at Harvard, you take 4 classes each that are worth 4 credits. You can opt to take 5, 6, or even 7 courses, but the more courses you go, the less recommended it is for you to do that. And I think actually, if you want to do more than 5 classes, you need to get special permission from like an advisor or something. I haven't done that as I was only in my freshman year and just getting adjusted to life at Harvard. So I was taking an intro to macroeconomics course. I was taking calculus 2, a class called introduction to law and literature, and a course called reform or revolution. And basically that course looked at how literature from the time of Plato until modern days reflects revolutionary or reformist attitudes among various societies and periods of time. I had a pretty good mix of lecture taught classes, discussion based classes, and smaller, tight-knit type lectures. And a pretty, I guess, as diverse of a course load as you can have for having only 4 courses. And so I would say, at first, I was doing all right maintaining my level of interest. Ooh. My level of interest in these courses and my level of, like, the effort that I was putting in, I guess. I was never not putting in effort, but as the semester continued, that amount of concentration and decided time set aside to do homework dwindled. Out of those 4 courses, the one that I was the most disappointed to have moved to an online format was my law and literature course. As I said, I'm studying economics and government, and I'm currently tentatively deciding to go to law school after my undergraduate studies, but I also just have a very deep personal interest in literature and the arts and humanities in general, but I really, really love literature, writing, anything like that. And so this course was just such a unique course with a great intersection between my professional interests in law and my personal interest in literature, taught by a visiting professor who really deeply cared about the syllabus and her students in general. Not that any of the other professors didn't care, of course, but it was taught in such a small, intimate lecture where even though it was a lecture, it did foster more discussion. And I just really, really loved that course. It was easily my favorite class of the semester. And when it got moved to an online format, of course, the ability to have a discussion with classmates fell to the wayside almost completely. And my professor was unable to host lecture in a live Zoom conference like a lot of the other professors were able to, because my professor has a 4-year-old daughter. She simply could not take enough time away to make sure she was uninterrupted and prepared for class at a specific schedule. So she had to send us the lectures in podcast form, which was nice, but it wasn't nearly the same amount. And so honestly, I would say the amount of educational value that I was getting from that course almost completely zeroed out from the time that I was at Harvard to the time that I had to take the course online. Furthermore, this course was lucky to be one that required, fortunate to be a course that required the writing of papers. Now, I know a lot of people perhaps are not big fans of writing papers, but one thing that I really love about writing academic papers is it forces you to take an active stance in your learning, because you have to engage with the material and formulate your own conclusions in some way. And so we had 2 response papers to the material that were due after we evacuated Harvard. This was particularly beneficial for me because I felt like the time that I took the most introspective look at the readings that we were assigned was during writing these papers. And for that value, I will say that my general education course, the Reform or Revolution one that I mentioned, was also uniquely relevant after leaving Harvard compared to my math and economics course, because that one also required a paper. It didn't require as frequent papers as the English course, the law and literature one, did, but this one required a massive final paper, about 12 pages of a paper. And so you had to make sure that you were paying at least a little bit of attention throughout the course to make sure that when it came time to write this 3,000 word essay with a prompt that you decided that was worth 50% of your grade, then you would be prepared. Because really and truly, if you did not pay attention to this course, which had very deep levels of difficulty when it came to the readings, as I said, we started off the semester reading Plato, and it was not very well translated to the modern reader. You still had very old English that you had to try to read. And so for this course, you couldn't really blow it off completely, because otherwise you would have the possibility of literally failing the course because you bombed the final essay, which was worth 50% of your grade. So this course, I think throughout it, I definitely did have a really hard time paying attention to what was going on, because the only assignments that we had were you had to show up to discussion section and submit like a paragraph of a response to the weekly readings, which if you really wanted to, and I'm going to admit I did it, I think once or twice, just skim a SparkNotes / listen very briefly to the lecture, and then you can write a paragraph easily that makes it kind of sound like you know what you're talking about. And so those were the only assignments we had up until the final paper. So the final paper really was what made sure that I like actually learned something from the course. And so I think honestly my learning in that class stopped after we left Harvard and then resumed when I began writing that final paper. Then we're gonna move on to my calculus course. My calculus course before leaving was the most challenging course, and so I especially was worried about this because math is notoriously hard to learn online. It just is. I don't think I know a single person that has said, you know what, I would rather take really hard math online than learn it from a real person. I just haven't. Harvard, of course, has a particularly difficult level of math that it teaches, okay? So we learn regular calculus too, but they teach it at such a depth that the calculus that I took before going to Harvard just barely scratched the surface. Like, they want you to know your shit, man. They want you to not only know the formula, but they want you to know why the formula came to be, and they want you to be able to produce the formula yourself. And all of these other iterations of just a depth of understanding, which is fantastic for institutions of higher learning. And honestly, I think for the greater good, as it may be, that might be the best approach toward teaching people mathematical and scientific concepts. But that does mean that the course, I'm sure this is true in other schools, not just Harvard, but it makes it much harder. And so here I am already like, oh my god, this class is so hard. It takes up so much time every week. And then, oh fuck, I need to have this course for my concentration, which is major in Harvard speak, because we have to have a different word for everything. I need this class as a requirement for my major. So I can't drop it. I can't fuck it up. And I'm still required to take more math that builds upon this class later on. And so I really couldn't just drop the ball and just fake it till I make it or anything like that, because I have to take multivariable calculus. Learning that over online lecture was really hard. And honestly, eventually I stopped going to online lecture after we finished our unit on infinite series and we moved on to differential equations. I just started reading the supplementary material that they would offer and watching like Khan Academy videos, which definitely was not the best way to learn it. And when you're going to Harvard, right, or really any institution, but in this case I'm talking about Harvard, so I'm going to keep mentioning Harvard, you're supposed to be learning from Harvard people. I could learn from Sal on Khan Academy right now if I wanted to. And so I definitely would say the amount of learning and the quality of education that I was receiving dwindled drastically prior to my move to my relocation. It just absolutely did. And I know that my mathematics course head and course assistants tried really, really hard to maintain some level of consistency from campus to the online format, but it just didn't exist. And it was really, really unfortunate, because I know that a lot of people were having similar struggles, and that was evident by the fact that the math department decided to lower the grade that you need to get a satisfactory, because Harvard moved every single one of its courses to an evaluation that was emergency, unsatisfactory, or satisfactory. And the baseline for SAT versus UNSAT is, I think, like 70%, but the math department decided that if you got a 60% overall in the course, then you would pass. And I was like, well, okay, I know I'm gonna get at least a 60% in the course. So really, I didn't really have to worry, but every single time that I would really not have any idea what I was doing and be like, oh my god, I'm so behind, I have no clue what is going on, I would feel like just such a fucking idiot. And I know that other people must have been feeling like that, because otherwise the math department would not have lowered the requirements to a 60% to pass. You know what I'm saying? Intellectually, I was aware that it was a universal struggle to adjust from on-campus mathematics to online, but still, I just wasn't learning as much, was confused way more often, and just felt way shittier about myself, which really just wasn't cool toward the end of the semester. As I said, we had 2 more months left of school. That just started to deteriorate my mental health and like self-esteem in terms of like, should I even be doing this? Am I smart enough to do this really hard math? Like, if I can't figure this out and I have all of this time in the world and I just can't do it, and I'm sitting here on my phone and like drawing or recording YouTube videos or watching YouTube videos or drinking and making coffee, if I can't budget my time appropriately and learn this material down pat when I have all the time in the world, then what the fuck am I supposed to expect myself to be capable of when I go out into my career? To some extent, I still think that I failed myself, honestly. And to some extent, I think that it was an inevitable result of such a traumatic mass movement in response to this virus, right? So it's kind of like still actually been a battle between what truly is something that I can't help and what is me being a victim of circumstance, when I don't personally believe that anyone should be a victim of circumstance if they truly apply themselves. But then here I am doing that exact same thing, right? I know that we're moving a little bit past, I haven't even gotten to my economics class yet, but it just has made me start questioning not my beliefs so much, because I still do believe all of this shit that I've spewed on this channel. all of those advicey type videos. I will leave some of those in the cards if you are interested. But I do believe that a person should take control of their own life and stop feeling sorry for themselves and all of that bullshit. But then here I am, not listening to myself. And I'm like, Jesus fuck, Alexa, grow the fuck up, do your math, but I don't know. And then when you go to economics, I'm literally majoring in economics. Therefore, it is immensely important that I understand just the basic fundamentals of macroeconomics to be able to move on to intermediate, to mastery, to perhaps a doctoral program in economics if I decide not to go to law school and I still want to go to graduate school. And then here I am, and it took me, because all of our lectures for this course were not pre-recorded, they would record them live, but then you could easily access them, and that was how the course was always run, actually. And so it was the most consistent in format from on-campus to off-campus. My brain was like, well, that's the least important one, it's the same as it was before, but really it's not the same because we didn't have in-person section discussion, which was really where I got all of the concepts down pat. Discussion isn't the same over Zoom. And unfortunately, I didn't realize how not the same it was going to be, so I kept pushing back those recorded lectures, and I was like, I'll catch up on them when I've caught up on the other three classes that I was falling behind in. I'll catch up on them later. And then finally, when I was like, okay, it's time to watch these lectures and take these practice tests and whatever, prepare for the final exam, I was like, Jesus Christ, I have no idea what's going on. And I still feel like since I left campus, I learned absolutely nothing about macroeconomics. The other three courses, I can say that I did learn at least something substantial, not as much as I would have before, but still learned a significant amount from before I left to now. But economics, I don't think really there's a single topic that I feel confident that I know what it was that we covered after the move, which freaks me out and still is scaring me because, as I said, that's my major. What the fuck am I supposed to do to build on it later? Thankfully, I have this entire summer where I don't have a job lined up anymore because of COVID-19. So I could take this opportunity and probably should, and I need to make myself take this opportunity to try to learn at least some of the fundamentals that I missed out on during the semester. But it's just a really scary thing where the vehicle for which the information was normally transferred from the teachers to me was altered so drastically, and the route from which it took from their mouths to my ears was made so much longer and windier that I'm just here trying to consume it as rapidly as I can and as thoroughly as possible within a few weeks to prepare for this final exam, and realizing that although the information is the same and the lectures look like they're being presented in the same format, it's really not the same path from teaching to understanding at all. And that was really scary because then that offers so many other implications for learning online in the fall semester, again, if that happens, like it's happening in Cambridge, or just human development, personal development in general. And I don't want to think about it anymore, but the TLDR is no, I did not receive the same level of education on campus versus online. No, I don't remember nearly as much from these online classes as I did in person. And no, I don't feel confident that I'm being prepared nearly as well for my career, for life in the real world, just for existence, as I was prior to moving. We shall move on to the part about me. Oh, you guys all care about me so much, right? So basically, I'm back at my house. Semester is over. How's she doing? She's doing okay. She has not been sleeping very well. I really don't know why. I can't fall asleep. I've been falling asleep at like 1 o'clock. I used to be staying up to like 4 a.m. Like not on purpose, but staying up till 4 a.m. and then waking up at like 1 or 2. But now I'm falling asleep at 1 and waking up at still 1, 2, 3 o'clock. And I don't know why, because I honestly have always kind of had a pretty poor sleep schedule. I am someone that definitely... What is happening? Hey! I'm somebody that has stayed up before, but then was able to wake up like at the latest noon, but usually would wake up around like 11. That would only happen when I would stay up really late, but it's like no matter what time I fall asleep, I still wake up at like 1, 2, 3. And that's not good because like I want to use this quarantine to do something. You know, as I said, I'm a pretty large proponent of making use of the resources you have to do something productive. And then here I am, and I'll set my alarm, it'll go off at 9, and I'm just so fucking exhausted. And then there's no reason for me to be so exhausted because I literally do nothing in the middle of the day anyway. I've been home for tomorrow, it will be exactly a week. I literally do nothing all day. I get up at like 1, 2, 3 o'clock, go make food, watch TV, do my makeup, drive around, and then I'm fucking exhausted. And I'm like, I don't know. But one thing that's really interesting is that like, I'm not a very emotionally volatile person. I don't react strongly emotionally to things in my life in general. I don't feel emotions very strongly very often. And so I have this weird thing where I don't actually know how I'm doing, if that makes sense. Alexa that is more depressed feels and reacts to the world very similarly to Alexa who is very satisfied with her life for the most part. Am I okay? I think I'm okay. I feel fine, but I'm not sure. You know what I mean? And then I look at the fact that I'm sleeping in really late and I'm getting nothing done. I'm like, maybe I'm not okay, you know? Like, that's not normal for me. So maybe that's an indication that I'm not doing well, but it's very strange because I am not feeling any strong emotions one way or the other. And I'm like, this is pretty consistent to how I've always been. So I'm not really sure. I remembered a part about my mental health and whatever that I forgot to add when I was recording this. So if I look a little bit different, it's been like half an hour. I just wanted to say that I've been having a really hard time keeping up with people from school. Like my roommate, who I love, I like barely talk to her. My Quidditch team, the band, I don't really like keep up with either of them very well. And it's really shitty, but I just have like no motivation to FaceTime slash Zoom slash any kind of video call or even really text them. There's like two people that I kind of consistently talk to from school. And it's not because I don't like them or that I think that they're annoying or anything. It's just, it takes like a really weird amount of mental energy to do it. Even though I know it's only like just text them, damn it, it's not that hard. It weirdly is, I don't know. So that's been a pretty big problem for me is because I feel like really guilty about it. And I do miss everybody. And so like, I feel really guilty about that because I do miss my friends. I do love my friends, but I also don't go to any of the like online video calls. And when I do, I kind of don't want to be there. I don't know, it's just sad. It just sucks. Yeah, that's about it. Yeah, I will be very glad to make another one of these videos documenting how I'm doing again. I mean, I can't really give you another video about how Harvard's doing because, you know, the semester's ended. But if you want to know later on how I'm doing personal life updates, and I will definitely do that. Just let me know in the comments or give the video a like. Giving a like is always helpful. Honestly, seriously, please give me a like. It helps me out more than you know. Let me know if there are any other videos that you want to see in the description down below. Comments. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you in my next video. Until then, I have an itch on my arm. Until then, I'm gonna go probably do nothing. Bye.